Hello dear students, in this video I will explain you about one more important provident fund scheme, that is recognized provident fund. In the last video I had explained you about the statutory provident fund which is available to the government employees. So this is the provident fund which is available to the private employees. So for government employees there are pension schemes and various other government schemes to help them even after their retirement. But when it comes to private employees, the question arises, what sort of schemes are there? So when it comes to the retirement schemes or retirement benefits, the recognized provident fund plays a vital role. So this recognized provident fund is a provident fund available to the private employees in order to safeguard their interest after retirement. So here also, just like any other fund, both employer and employee will contribute a certain fixed amount towards a fund which is created in the name of provident fund, and it will be invested in the market securities. And whatever the interest which is generated from that fund will be reinvested, and the fund grows, and ultimately at the time of retirement that amount will be given to the employee along with interest and all other benefits. There are provisions of this fund as well, so let's learn the important provisions of this recognized provident fund. This fund has been established as per the provisions of part A of the 4th schedule of Income Tax Act of 1962, and it is approved by the Commissioner of Income Tax. So as I said, it is for private employees. So any private employer can establish this fund for the benefit of employees. So once this fund has been established, it must get the approval of the Commissioner of Income Tax. So only then it will be called as a recognized provident fund. So once it is being recognized by the provident fund, the employees will get the benefit of this fund just like any other funds. So the benefits or the provisions goes like this. The first one is employee's contribution is included in salary. As I have mentioned in the last video, whatever the salary employee receives in that month, in that salary a portion will be contributed to this fund. Just like SPF, in RPF also a contribution will be there by employee towards this fund. So that contribution whatever he makes is part of his salary, it is part of his gross salary. And when we compute the income tax of that individual employee or that assessee, that contribution will be included for tax purpose. It is part of salary, it is part of tax as well. But you can claim the deduction for that later. And the second important condition is about the employer's contribution. So whatever employer contributes in addition to the salary given to the employee, that is not fully exempt here. In the case of SPF, it is fully exempt from tax. But in the case of RPF, it is exempt only up to the extent of 12% of the salary of the employee. So salary means here basic plus DA. For example, in SPF, if employee is contributing 1800, employer will also contribute 1800, both gets exempted fully. But in the case of RPF, if employee contributes, that is taxable, and the employer contribution, that will not be in the form of amount, will be in the form of percentages. If employer is contributing 15% of the basic and DA of the employee, then in that 15%, difference between 15% and 12%, the difference of 3% is taxable. Up to 12% the contribution gets exempted, above 12% it becomes taxable. So that's how it works in the case of RPF. And next important point is about the interest what employee receives in this fund. So interest also generated for the investments they have made in this fund or with the help of this fund, that interest is also not fully exempt like SPF. So here it is also exempt only to the extent of 9.5%. Above 9.5% it is taxable. If the interest is given at the rate of 12%, it is not fully exempt. Difference between 12% and 9.5%, that is 2.5%, is taxable. Taxable means here that will be added to the salary of the employee while computing income from salary, and it becomes taxable. And next important point is about the accumulated balance. So over a period of time, whatever the contribution made by both employer and employee and interest generated, reinvested amount, everything put together, it will be a very big lump sum amount. So at the time of retirement, employee will receive that accumulated balance, and that balance whatever he receives at the time of his retirement or maybe at the time of his death, and that amount is a very big income for that individual employee. And that accumulated balance, that big income, is fully exempt from tax in the case of RPF also, as per section 10 subsection 12 of the Income Tax Act. And last important point about this is the eligibility for claiming deductions. In SPF also, whatever employee contributes is eligible for deduction under section 80C. Similarly, in the case of RPF also, what employee is contributing, That's what I said in the case of example, that if it is 1,800 rupees, a fixed sum, a fixed amount in that month, if it is 1,800, that 1,800, as it was included in the salary initially, at the end of the calculation, the same 1,800 he can claim as a deduction under section 80C. So, various deductions are provided to the assessees in order to reduce their tax burden, in order to motivate them to file income tax returns. So, one such deduction is 80C. So, in 80C, this contribution what an employee has made towards the RPF, he can claim that as a deduction. So, while concluding, I can tell you that this is a fund which is exclusively provided to the private sector employees. So, private sector employees can opt this scheme only when this fund is recognized by the Commissioner of Income Tax. So, this is also a very important provident fund, but compared to statutory provident fund, this is not that beneficial. But in order to safeguard the interest of private employees, the schemes and provisions of this provident fund is really beneficial, reasonable. And almost all the private sector companies and employers offer this benefit to the employees, and thousands of employees are benefited by this scheme. So, this is about the recognized provident fund, one of the important retirement schemes of the government of India. Then in the next video, I will take up the remaining types of provident funds. Thank you.